What is up, guys? Philip here with Satisfye, and today we are going to be learning about the Ryze pads and recommended configurations for each console. Let's check it out. All right, so let's start with the PlayStation. Now, the PlayStation, we've got the PlayStation 4 and the PlayStation 5. Both of these controllers are actually pretty different, and the configurations I like to use on the PlayStation 4 are actually different than the ones I like to use on the PlayStation 5. So starting with the PlayStation 4, my absolute favorite go-to configuration is the swivel pad on the left and the extended notch on the right. I just prefer the extended notch. I love the way it feels. So just to be clear, on the swivel pad, this is only meant for your left joystick, not for the right, and that goes for every console that you have, whether it's Nintendo, PlayStation, or Xbox, always a swivel on the left. You can put it on the right. You're probably not gonna like it though. It's meant for the movement of the character, and that's where it's best, and it's really at home. You can mix and match these between the left and right joystick to your heart's content, and you're gonna find that different games are gonna feel better for different things. All right, so let's look at the PS5 controller. On this controller, I actually prefer two wave pads, the standard and extended. Now, the PS5 left joystick is quite a bit more of a stretch to reach it than it is on the PS4. And I found that when I hold the controller like I want to, like this, I get a pain with or without any pads on this left side. So I've learned I have to hold it more like this, kind of like more of a dainty hold. And with that, this feels amazing. It's just tracking all over the place. I've been playing a ton of Call of Duty as well as Demon's Souls using this setup, and this is by far my go-to setup on the PS5. All right, so now let's look at the Xbox Series X, Elite, Xbox One. They're all gonna be the same, and they all have the same configuration, which is my go-to. It's a swivel on the left and an extended notch on the right. I just feel like, for me, it's just perfect. What's amazing about these pads is they're so flexible. You can go from the extended to the standard based on your hand size, based on your reach. There's a lot of variables in here. But for me, my go-to, whether I'm playing a first-person shooter or a third-person, it's definitely this configuration. Now, with the Nintendo Switch and Switch Lite, both are the same on your Joy-Cons. This is very, I find this has like the most necessity to swap in and out on different sizes and styles. So if I had to pick my go-to for this console, it's gonna be a swivel on the left and an extended wave on the right. I just love the way this wave allows me to reach the buttons and manipulate these while still controlling this with the bottom part of my thumb. That's really helpful. But you know, the notch on the left is gonna feel really good too. A nice low notch on the left, the standard size, it feels amazing. You wanna angle it at the way that your thumb enters into that joystick, and yeah, it feels really good. You really can't go wrong here. There's so much flexibility for hand sizes with these that every option's a good option. It's just based on you. So really, there is no wrong configuration. It's whatever works for you. With the 5-pack, you have maximum customization. This is a great product. You guys are absolutely going to love these Ryze pads. All right, you guys, so that wraps it up. I hope that video was helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter @SatisfyeGaming, and we will see you guys in the next video.